Okay, so we are at the Manhattan School, and we are with Sergeant Belette. This is the first time that I met Sergeant, because we never met before. So it could be a good opportunity also to introduce Sergeant to our followers on the Savarese TV. So Sergeant, first, where do you come from?
I come from Split, Croatia, and very excited to be here at the GFA convention in New York. It's been quite a journey, but I'm happy that I arrived and I'm here.
Okay, and is this your first GFA?
No, I've been here a couple of times. Last time was quite a while ago, perhaps a bit over a decade, so I revealed my age as well. I always had a great time at GFA. I am particularly excited that it's in New York because it's one of my favorite places in the world, really.
And did you do the competition or not or never?
Yeah, I did it the last time I was here. It was maybe didn't go as I hoped it would because I was eliminated in the second round. And actually, fun fact, that's the only competition where I didn't win an award in my career. So, I mean, yeah, it's a very tough competition. A lot of great players come out of it, and you know, that time it was just an honor for me to be there. And then a couple of weeks after that, I won Benikasim, the Tarek competition.
Okay, and do you teach guitar in your country, or do you belong to a music school, or do you have students?
No, I'm kind of at the moment where I have an impossible job because I do a lot of freelance work, and I'm a freelance concert artist, you know, whatever that means. So I really try to get out there and play as much concerts as possible. As you know, it's really challenging, especially in a post-COVID world with all of the cancellations and disappearances of events. So this is why I'm especially just glad to be here and to keep things going, you know.
Okay, so do you have a website or an Instagram to contact you, if you want to contact you?
Yeah. Of course, yeah, I'm on social media, I have a website. I actually just finished a new website, and hopefully we'll put a link to it below the video.
Okay, so you tell me, when did you discover your first Savarese set, string set?
Yes, because it was such a big event for me. I just bought my first, I call it the real guitar, because when I was in like elementary school and like a really junior level, I played on, I don't know if I can sponsor anyone, but a really cheap Yamaha guitar, and it was kind of ridiculous. And strings, I don't even remember what they were, so I cannot believe that I survived that period. So when I was in my first year in high school, I distinctly remember buying Savarese strings. It was such a huge deal for me, and I just loved them immediately. For some reason I just responded to them very well, and I played on them ever since, yeah, for 22 years.
And do you remember which set is it?
I remember that they were blue, so I think in terms of design, it was very similar to the ones that I currently use, which is the high tension 500 AJ, right? But were they that? I am not sure, to be honest. But I think there were something similar. I don't know when exactly did you develop the carbon technology, but I think they were maybe the same strings, but I'm not sure. I only remember going to the store and it was a field trip for me.
So why are you there? Why are you at the GFA? So today for a lecture, you told me?
Yes, so yesterday I had a lecture here at GFA. I was very excited to be invited as one of the guest lecturers, and I gave a presentation on how to prepare for concert performances as sort of a practical guide. I think it's a very personal topic, so it was a huge step for me to talk about it publicly, but I'm glad I did because it's a really important topic, you know, and concert performances, live performances, that's something that we should really value.
So you didn't break your guitar, but tell us about your guitar. Is it a luthier from your country, or which guitar is it?
I love my guitar, but I never travel without it. So when I had the opportunity to travel without it, I was really excited. Because as you know, traveling with a guitar is a nightmare, even when everyone is super nice. So this was really a vacation for me, at least the plane trip. I play on a cedar guitar by a Croatian luthier. His name is Želimir Semer, the senior. He's the father of that luthier family. I played on his guitar for also 20 plus years. A lot of other great Croatian guitarists have played on his guitar. One of Ana Vidović's first guitar was one of his also cedar custom-made guitar. So he's a true artist, in my opinion. And very happy that we have this really long and fruitful collaboration, as well as a personal friendship.
And do you have a special for the next month? Are you going to have some concert, or do you have a special news to share with us?
I have a lot of concerts back home, and being back home is actually kind of the place to be in July and August, because I'm guessing that Dalmatian coast is now the new Monte Carlo or something. It's very popular, and actually now I live in the center of Split, so it can be a bit New York in terms of loudness and busyness. It's really crazy when I think about it, because 10 years ago I was just fine being asleep, you know. Now you cannot really, it's now Split is a city that never sleeps. So I have a concert almost like every week, which is great, especially since, you know, past couple of years it was really a challenge to get booked. So I have that, and I have some international projects as well in Belgium, going to Switzerland. I'm trying to kind of venture out into other spaces besides the guitar world, and I do a lot of chamber work as well. So a lot of new exciting projects, but the only thing that remains is me and some other strings. That's the only constant.
And when you prepare a concert, who is your famous composer? Do you play Bach, Roland Jens, or
who is your favorite composer?
In terms of guitar, let's say standard guitar repertoire, my always go-to is Regondi. I will always champion his work. I think he was a remarkable artist, and that kind of mid-19th century period really speaks to me for some reason personally, even though I was born 130 years after that. So I would definitely pick him as one of my favorite composers. And also I play a lot of Croatian composers. I have a degree in contemporary music, and I really try to champion that as well, because I think there's a lot of really valuable material that maybe not a lot of people are familiar with.
Okay. Anything else that you want to share with us? Anything else that you want to share with us, with your social network or something like that, that you can tell if you want to contact you?
All that, yeah. I mean, please do. I'm available for booking. No, I'm kidding. If people have any questions, or they want to ask me something, especially about my lecture in GFA, if they want me to share some links, some of the work that I do, so feel free to visit my website. I'm more than happy to communicate and to share what I do with other people. And I think I would be so bold to say that I turned a lot of people to, for example, Savare Strings. So, yeah.
Okay. Thank you for this interview, and see you soon for our next one.